is to me some very special thing. A kind of secret communication that needs no justification or answer. I have always marveled at the wonderful letters of the world. July 28, 1943. Dear David, I have been reading poetry lately because it is so much what it is. This is Dylan Thomas, Love in the Asylum. A stranger has come to share my room, not right in the house, in the head. A girl, mad as birds, bolting the night of the door with her arm, her plume. Straight in the maze bed, she deludes the heaven-proof house with entering clouds. Yet she deludes with walking the nightmarish room, at large as the dead, or rides the imagined oceans of the male words. She has come possessed, who admits the delusive light through the bouncing wall. Possessed by the sky, she sleeps in the narrow trough. Yet she walks to dust, yet raves at her will on the madhouse boards worn thin by my walking tears. And taken by light in her arms at long and dear last, I may without fail suffer the first vision that set fire to the stars. Magic about them, and I am undone by them and completely done again in the faith halls of my mind. That is faith, I think, David. September 27, 1944. Dear David, there is one man I have not known before. Save John Peirce. His real name is Alexis Saint-Leger, one of the principal officers of the Third Republic in France, who is now in exile here. He was born in the island possessions, and his poetry is just that, as Jean Erdman is the island in some inner way. Rhythms of pride descend the red morns. Turtles roll in the narrows like brown stars. Roadsteads stream dreams full of children's heads. Now these calm waters are of milk, and all things overflowing in the soft solitudes of morning. This is my final letter to you, David. Please remember that the arts are a mission for a salvation of the world, and that your precision and concentration must be as deadly as if in a matter of life and death. So, whatever you elect yourself to prepare for this, and whatever field you enter, you must carry your secret purpose in your heart and feed on that in moments of anguish and peril.